Right, guys, I've got another one for you. They seem to be coming through thick and fast today. It's great. So, comes to work on this car, and that's not doing out. So, we're going to get it sorted. I'll bring you along for the ride. So, we're back. So, obviously, you saw the handle all loose inside. Now, I've managed to get underneath. So, this is what we have to do. You have to take the under tray off, and you have to undo the bonnet manually, if you like, which is getting hold of this cable here and pulling it. So here's the cable. So we'll show you what's happened now. So if you have a look here, that's extremely dry. That's not going to help what we're going to see now. So the cable comes in two halves. You get that part here, and you get the front half. So that goes from the bonnet into the car, and that goes from here across the front end to the catch. Now what's happened is that catch has obviously been a bit too much for the cable, and ripped this end off. So what should happen is this ball will fit in a tab that's there and then pull and work in perfect sync, if you like. It ain't doing that, so it needs the front part of the cable to replace this bit, and then that latch needs sorting, just so we know where we're at. So I'll bring you back for the finished article, guys. And yeah, this happens quite a lot on Golf and Passat. We're back at the Golf R now. It is the next day. We had to order some parts. And here we go. So I've stripped it down just so you can see. It's not that difficult, but I'll take you through the motions anyway. So this is the old catch, absolutely horrendous. This is obviously the new shiny new catch, and you do get the sensor with it. I'll show you where that plugs in just a second. The new part of the cable, so as you saw in the earlier bit of the video, it's been round. That bit's actually there, so the cable can just attach in there as it's supposed to, whereas if you look at this one, it's snapped off. So we're going to get rid of these parts now. We don't need these. Now we're going to get to fitting the new bits. So all they do is the thread from here, so you've got these two holes here, which is where them two tabs sit, and then it threads down here. I know you want it upside down, so the plug sits there, the cable fits through this hole just here, goes along the front, one groove there, it sits on the little ledge and then bolts in to there. So your wiring and your cable will come through here, you catch your bolt on there, jobs are good. And so what I'm going to mention is there's a couple of things again I'm not going to show on this video. So I have removed the grill, which has got the sensor in it, so just after this video and after I've done the repair, we'll be having a front assist calibration, so don't worry about that is getting done. Just that's for another video. So we'll get to fixing this and I'll bring you back along. Apologies for the noise, guys. We've got oil pumps going off all over the place and all that. But now I'm going to show you it all fitted. So we'll start this side. So new cable there. So this side forward, it's in its hole there. So it goes through there. You've got your new wire as well, all plugged in its brackets. All tucked in nicely across the front. There's the new catch. And I've already put some special grease in there. Stop this from happening again. They're all torqued to spec. We don't want a bonnet flying open. So now I'm going to fit the grill, guys, calibrate it up, and send it on its way. So thank you for coming along for this one, guys. It's been a couple of days, but yeah, nonetheless, it's all sorted. Thank you again, guys, and I will see you again shortly.